Thank you. Initiation of the Lord Jesus again. It was quiet in times of loss. She drenched herself in my feminine blood with seduction of the first degree. She was seduction. Painless pleasure. of unfettered ease. It's
Blood red roses. Charming laughter of blood red roses. Blood of the centuries of blood. Gentle to feel what I feel. Attentive to this very moment. Kiss me. Kissing me on the blue, kissing me on my face, turning bright blue. Sapphire, kissing me in the red on the sapphire. Turning me in the bathtub of blue and red roses, and see what happens next. This is the only thing that I ever loved. She walked towards me. Silence in her eyes. I heard the name. We were charmed in the mystery. As she stepped into the red light, her hair is black, her flesh is white. My consciousness is enveloped with the sun. I feel the legs wrapped around me. She was a sensation of a red glass.
Such a vicious, I do not know how to respect.
and to the latter. Our spirit is physical, literal, and transcends and trusts for our eternity. So this is next people and lover, and I dedicate it to the subject of death. This is one of our slashed veins. Blood flow from the jugular, slashed veins, blood at the nose. She flashed faint, blunt into the air, in her brother's arms, desired to die as one hour, then in her head in her brain, then everything before. This man that I had wrote is his old dark thoughts. Seated in the living, alone, the feeling of a leaf for me, burdened and bloated with luminous cat, the sight of life that goes on. In the every drop of blood, I'm bleeding no longer from my heart. This is healed, and I feel stronger, for it keeps me from suffering on. To be renewed, I am now unchained. And I am afraid to discover again. I am afraid to be the ever-changing metamorphosis that I am.
One of my favorite bands is the Cure.
So this next poem, I will describe Cure for the Coming Dead. We are animals tonight, food for the blood and sex, flesh rotting, fire flames, burning. As it was trial, burn, watch me burn. Lasting for human sacrifice, cut into the slit. This is my latest slit. No function, dysfunctional. Terror. The 15th is coming soon. Close now, the universe. Slit, cut, bleed. Cut, slit, bleed. Bleed, slit, cut. Over. Bleed, bitch.
Bleed, fucking bitch.
Just bring your hair back your head. All is done. Before it all over, bleed, you fucking bitch, bleed, care for the coming days. Okay. This next poem.
I guess it's a day dedicated to death or a vampirism on the blood.
This is called the Herald. This poem is called Faint.
F-A-I-N-T.
Faint. Visions look through the skull. And she sees that there is a blade. Her veins are close to the death fate. She is saddened by existence. Her eyes are blue with rage. The emotions are in the air. She wants to slash. Yet her world is too wired. But the fact she's starving behind her smile and silky. Selfie tears that roll down her face. She thinks of herself. There is a blade hit home. Her life sunk down the sink of the bathroom sink. The next poem is called that I wrote Fade in You. Last kiss of my most serious was ever so there, quite passionate. Her not wanting me to fade into the darkness that shined through the universe. This next poem is called Unspoken Truth in Your Touch. Feeling the breeze of the morning rush from my fingers and collapse over me, wet as I ever was, and feeling fucking beautiful in her arms, her kiss. They whisper million words. That was unspoken truth. That is found in her touch. Some of my earlier works, but that's okay. This one I wrote is called Young or Why Do You Aim H-O-L-E. With a smooth, clear liquid in its own over my face, save the taste on my fingers. It shares a little taste in and wanting more. totally exposed. She is naked. No holding back. Well, Here's one. A root, spicy red. She took me in her mouth. Water fell on me and I danced in the light. The high ashes swallowed and turned to me. I soaked her face. We sat by the fire. The kiss of heat. And I here, standing, void exposed. Not waiting for anything, just her mouth upon me. This one I wrote about my former lesbian love many years ago. This one is called my former love. I remember when she took me that night, feeling the touch of her hand, felt like silk. The scent of this must be, you taste like good age. Red in mine. I heard the faint whisper of her voice. Calling out. Your voluptuous body. Your full lips. Devoured my innocent flesh. I remember the moments. The aura of a soldier moved. Each kiss brought me sudden pleasure. My thoughts of you are this nature. A beautiful woman who took me that night. You gave me such pleasure that I never forget. separated. Even though we are apart from one another, I'll always address you as my former lover. For always. This one is called that I wrote about another beautiful woman that I was with. I titled this Passion Manners. I swear I saw your face in the middle sky. During that night, I often thought of you. Patience was the only one that was together when we were together. Your passion kisses, your sensual voices, the way the moon was that I was with you when we were together. As you crossed my body, I fell into a trance. As we embraced each other close, while lying there, I feel the warmth of the fire, the seasonal sunshine on my body. It gives me peace of mind. When we lay low in the rain, the sound of the thunder. Allowed when you are rushing me with your mood, my soul is shattered with yours. Passion nights, you and I together. Nights of ecstasy. All right, my darlings, this next time I read. I titled this poem, I wrote, slowly reach my hunger for you. The lightness of your lips, feeling the warmth of your smile, passion within is as my juice drip. As we lay in bed, I can still feel the glow of your fingers slide within my inner thighs. And slowly reach my hunger for you. Suddenly, sensation of sheer pleasure curses me from ceiling to floor. My body starts to quiver by your touch. You quench your desire of thirst by sapping up my dripping blood, Jesus. I grow intense with a sensual desire to fuck you with great admiration. To fuck you with great attention. To fuck you. And you want to fuck me. You kiss me as I kiss you. Your lips are soft. We start to kiss each other, sweep your heart, each other. I can feel you like honey, as we are made of our bodies move and emotion. We move in rhythm. I can feel the sensation of ecstasy rising. Even more hotter than ever, you are mine, and always will be.
Bringing sensations that I've never felt before. All right, my darlings, this is called Last Night.
Your love that I care, your big hands struggling, until I reached the moment's pleasure, as I did, I called out to you. Says that I am throughout the night, last night. I could feel several emotions being released at that moment. Last night was most memorable, for its deep and intimate whispers from you. Your fingers slid inside me, and I sighed with ecstasy last night, several times throughout the night. This next poem that I wrote was an earlier work of mine. I actually experienced it with another beautiful lesbian love of mine. I titled this one, Struggle as a Lady of Mine. Tell me, sweet, one bead in my mind, two hearts beating as one, as you are making my way in the middle of the night. And if you struggle with any dream, that the order from the universe, just you and me, and a bottle of red wine, a crate of lettuce, juicy red strawberries, as we take these strawberries, you slide inside me. In and out, that's how juicy the dinner is. and as I learned from my mother, after such beautifulness, it's a take of a bottle of red wine and pour it over me as you do with your daughter, looking and drinking every night and tooth, every night, every red wine off my body. It's a call to me. With you, there is passion. Because we did this out of the love of our hearts, and that's all. For I always remember you and cherish this moment with you, and the strawberries and the red wine.
Alright, my darlings. This next poem I wrote is really beautiful woman. She is from Tokyo, Japan. I call this Tokyo Fan. A long black hair, silk coming in the dark. Her pale white flesh, soft and delicate. A Tokyo essence, the scent that filled the room with my memories. Drinking Sapphire, she smiles as I get the moment into her. And her Japanese calm, sweet, nectar like. It tastes like orange nectar. And in her, a white face. Everything glowed red. Blue, black, black, blue, orange, nectar. From the peaked memory of Tokyo. Asian lesbian lover. I titled this Oriental Flower. As we kiss, I caress your body, fondling your body, overlooking your sweet nectar. Women in love, deep desires of love that's within us. You, my Oriental Flower. This one is about another beautiful lesbian. My veins are penetrable once more. My arms are tired. With a physical resistance. Her nails and claws, her veins cut into my flesh. My fresh blood for her to drink and dry, till there's no left to feed on.
is still raining, my darlings. It is such a beautiful day. I'm so glad that I could create this audiobook for you. Let's see, my darklings. What else can we dig up?
What else is there for me to read?
Probably a lot.
Because this next audiobook that I create for you will be a lot more. So stay tuned, my darlings.
It's so wet.
Beautiful. Such a beautiful morning in the afternoon. It really is. Alright, let's see what I can read for you. This poem that I wrote about her and I is called
daddy sex.
This is Laura Valentina.